If you are from the UK, you're gonna wanna hear this. Dozens of news headlines read today that the British public could face conscription into the army if they go to war with Russia. Now, this warning comes from the Army Chief, General Sir Patrick Saunders, in a speech that he gave today, where he stressed that the government needs to mobilize the nation because the military numbers are so low. Now, it's understood that the Army Chief doesn't support conscription, but believes that there needs to be a shift in the mindset of the public, who should be willing to defend the UK against foreign adversaries. But this all got me thinking, how would a conscription in 2024 even work? Because firstly, thanks to the internet, we now have access to so much more information and war propaganda to make you think all Russians and Chinese are evil wouldn't really work to rally the population anymore. And secondly, who would be conscripted? Because in World War II, it was mandatory for all men aged 18 to 41 to register for service. But since we live in a world where traditional gender roles are changing, would we see a more equal call-up between men and women? And if we did need women to stay at home so they could have children and babies to keep the population going, how the hell would they even afford to have babies? Because we all know that the current cost of living crisis has got people infertile right now. So the question is, if you were called up to fight, would you go willingly or not?
One of the jurors on the Alec Murdoch case, who found him guilty of murdering his wife and son last year, testified this morning that comments made by the clerk of court influenced her verdict. The hearing being held today is to determine if Murdoch should receive a new trial, as his attorneys allege that clerk of court Rebecca Hill tampered with the jury. Murdoch's attorneys allege that Hill inappropriately discussed the case with jurors, pressured them to conclude deliberations quickly, and misrepresented information to the trial judge about a juror who was ultimately dismissed. They claim she did this, quote, to secure for herself a book deal and media appearances that would not happen in the event of a mistrial. Hill has denied these claims. However, in a hearing today, one juror who was identified as Juror Z testified that she was influenced by remarks Hill made. Juror Z told the judge that prior to coming to a verdict, she heard the clerk say to watch his actions and to watch him closely. She said that Hill's comments, quote, made it seem like he was already guilty. The judge asked Juror Z if Hill's comments affected her finding of guilt, and she responded, yes, ma'am. Hill is expected to also testify today, along with the 10 remaining jurors. One juror testified on Friday due to scheduling conflicts, and they said that Hill's comments did not influence their verdict. If the judge decides that Hill's comments influenced the jury, whether intentional on her part or not, the judge may decide to grant Murdoch a new murder trial. In that case, his conviction will be vacated, his life sentence will be overturned, and it will be as if he was never convicted, and everything will have to start from scratch again. So we'll see where this goes, but stay tuned.
One of the world's scariest animals just got a whole lot scarier. And Planet of the Apes is slowly becoming nonfiction, as apparently chimpanzees are out here murking gorillas. Scientists in 2021 witnessed a troop of chimpanzees basically jumping a family of gorillas. And when I say gang, we're talking about almost 30 chimps pressing a family of five. Keep in mind, a silverback can weigh up to 400 pounds and could probably bench press your car. And according to witnesses, the silverback was eating chimps left and right like they were paper mache. But eventually the chimps overwhelmed the bigger silverback and even kidnapped a baby gorilla. I'm not gonna tell you exactly what they did, but that family of five became a party of four. And it wasn't even the last time, because later that year, scientists watched the same group of chimpanzees do the same exact thing. Square up with a family of gorillas, kidnapped a baby, and erase its name from the gorilla census. And it's not like we didn't know chimps were about that. They often hunt bush babies and vervet monkeys, and we've even seen them use weapons like spears to do it. But it's one thing to hunt something that weighs like five Skittles. Going gorillas is another tier of Black Air Force activity, which is why I'd rather be locked in a room with a jaguar than a chimp. Cause at least the jaguar gonna make it quick.
This girl killed her mum so that she wouldn't find out she got kicked out of school. On the 3rd of March 2020, police were called to do a welfare check at a property in Ohio. Brenda Powell lived in the house, the 50-year-old mother of Sydney Powell. Brenda had actually been on the phone with Sydney's former school. This was the University of Mount Union. Now, during the telephone call, a staff member heard repeated thuds and screaming, so authorities were alerted. Inside, they found Brenda Powell in a serious condition. She was rushed to hospital but died from her injuries. Brenda had been unaware that her 19-year-old daughter had been kicked out of the school. During her telephone conversation, Brenda was struck in the head and then stabbed nearly 30 times by Sydney. However, when police investigated the murder, Sydney tried to claim that there had been a break-in. She told them that there had been a noise and her mum had instructed her to run away. She said she heard screaming and when she ran back in, her mum was on the floor. Investigators saw through her lies and she eventually changed her story. At her trial, she pled not guilty by reason of insanity. Her defence argued that Sydney was suffering from undiagnosed schizophrenia. They stated that she killed while experiencing a psychotic episode. However, it is rare for people with schizophrenia to act violently. It was concluded that Sydney had been exaggerating her symptoms. She's recently been found guilty and is awaiting sentencing.
Korean people don't use deodorant because they don't have the gene that produces body odor. Facts you didn't know about. I bet you can't solve the riddle at the end. Android cameras are better than iPhone cameras. Comment what type of phone you have and then click more. Would you do it? St. Lucia is the only country in the world that is named after a woman. The word burrito means little donkey in the Spanish language, and no one knows why they chose that name. 77% of people in Uganda are under the age of 30 years old. Squirrels cause about 10 to 20% of power outages in the U.S. On average, men get bored of shopping after about 25 minutes. Before the riddle at the end, like this video and follow me to learn new facts and get smarter every day, here's the riddle. What kind of tree can you carry in your hand?
The world needs to know what is happening across Europe right now. In countries across the continent, farmers have been taking to the streets in protest against their respective governments, saying that their policies are destroying their livelihoods. In France, not only have tractors blocked multiple vital roads leading to cities like Paris, but have also dumped dirt, stones, rubble, and even hay bales on key motorways. They also set fire to foreign produce and poured out all of the wine that was imported. They tore up parking lots in the south using their tractors. They sprayed an estimated 17,000 liters of sewage on government buildings and even tried to shoot it in their windows. And then to counteract that, they planned probably one of the most peaceful protests the world has ever seen by filling the center of Draguignan with sheep. They even lined up hundreds of tractors on Le Touquet Beach, which is where the French president Macron has a holiday home. In Germany, thousands took to the streets to protest the phasing out of tax breaks on agricultural diesel, which they say would lead them to bankruptcy. Italy joined the protest with signs that read, "No farmers, no food, no future." This is what it looked like in Belgium yesterday, with tractors as far as the eye can see blocking important motorways as they protest a variety of issues, from low pay to climate regulations. In Romania, Poland, and Hungary, farmers protested against the EU's policies to allow cheap Ukrainian imports to flood the market, which they say has left them unable to sell their crops. Farmers in Scotland said enough is enough and took to the streets with the phrase, "Our land, our livelihood, our future." None of us survive without farmers, and that's why
I don't care what anybody says. This is absolute insanity. Like, I don't care whose side you on. I don't care, girl. This is too far. So, allegedly, police are now involved to protect the grave of Megan Thee Stallion's mother. A source said that somebody leaked the address of Megan Thee Stallion's deceased mother's grave to allegedly, you know, get a bunch of people to go defame her, this woman's mother's grave. What is wrong with people? Every day I'm honestly reminded that people are just so crazy and just evil and vile over a person, 9 times out of 10, over a person they don't even know. Like, but yeah. Be so for real. Like, come on now. This is too far.
I know I can't afford to stop for one moment.
fucking pack off of the porch or break a pound down. Get the scrap if it happens to blow, it makes a round sounds. Pussycat on my lap, push it back and go to town down. Putting rap on my back and I'm black and snatching crowns. How they came back around like a nigga selling crack in pounds. I got a bag now, but it's nothing to brag about. Gun blast in the background, I'm a black man with the bloodhounds. Mac 10 making love sounds to a bitch.
What are you doing?
This is a gun, keep driving.
No, it's not. Stop. Come on, man. I got a family. What are you doing?
I have a family too, not drive.
What are you doing?
Drive.
Please stop.
I have the power, miss.
I have four kids. What are you doing? Drive.
What you just saw were some of the final moments of Uber driver Christy Spicuzza's life. This is an extremely sad and horrific story. Christy Spicuzza was a mother from Pennsylvania who worked for Uber. She had a loving family, and on the night of February 10, 2022, she was expecting to just work her normal shift on Uber. But on that tragic night, Christy picked up this man, Calvin Crew. Now, Christy had a dash cam video camera which was facing her and her passengers. And for the first 20 minutes or so of this ride, Calvin just sat in the back seat not saying anything, and Christy even tried to ask him questions like, did you have a good day? How's it going? But at one point, Calvin pulls out a pistol, places it against Christy's skull, and informs her that she needs to drive. Now, Christy would continue to drive, and she begged the man in the backseat for her life, talking about her amazing children and her family and how it doesn't have to go like this, but it seems like Calvin's mind was already decided. And just 2 days later, Christy's car and her dead body were found in a neighboring area. Calvin had forced Christy to drive out to an isolated wooded area and murdered her out in the woods. After the murder, Calvin had used Christy's cell phone to access some of her financial apps like Cash App and sent himself some money, but it wasn't even a very large sum of money that this man stole. Calvin's girlfriend, Tania Mullen, was actually the one who called the Uber for her boyfriend that night, and she had even texted him that evening and said, I'm not going to jail if we get caught. Which is true, because she never ended up going to jail or prison for her involvement in this horrifically sad crime. This is just such a tragic story that obviously did not need to happen, and that footage is some of the most horrifying that I've ever seen.
Nobody wants you dead more than your baby mama. This is 34-year-old Samantha Washington from Houston. She was married to 28-year-old Gregory Kirk, and they had 3 children, but they were separated. Once they became separated, Samantha realized that her children will never be more of a priority than ending the life of her ex-husband-to-be. So she hatched a plan. She thought, I'm gonna go to his job when he's having his lunch break, and I'm gonna bring his 3-year-old son, and I'm gonna let him play with his 3-year-old son on his lunch break. Then I'm gonna approach him from behind with a firearm on surveillance camera in front of his coworkers and shoot him, and he's gonna fall down and die. But he didn't die. He was begging for his life, and she realized the job wasn't finished. So she went back and shot him in the heart to make sure he was out of here, so she could have her 3 kids to herself and run off into the sunset. But that's not what happened. She was arrested, and she was charged with first-degree murder, and they gave her 25 years to life. And if she cared about her kids at all, she would have prioritized being a mother to her kids instead of ending the life of her baby daddy. Let this be a cautionary tale to you men out there. Nothing is more important than your baby mama ending your life. Not raising her kids, not moving forward, not being in a new relationship, not becoming an upstanding citizen, none of that. She ain't going to therapy. She going to get a gun, and she going to find a way to get you up out of here. Y'all be safe though.
This 19-year-old TikToker was murdered while filming a TikTok video. This is 19-year-old Anaya Womack, a woman from Jacksonville, Florida. Anaya was really active on her TikTok and her Instagram, and she really wanted to grow her following. In May of 2023, Anaya was brought to a hospital and dropped off with a gunshot wound in her stomach. After she was dropped off and left there, she died. And 135 days later, the story finally began to unfold. So Anaya's family had fought tooth and nail for justice, for answers. They just had no idea what had happened to her. I mean, how did she end up with that gunshot wound? Who drove her to the hospital? Well, eventually Mariah J. Clayton, a 20-year-old friend of Anaya's, was arrested. So at first, Mariah and the man she was with claimed that they were driving down the street when they somehow stumbled across Anaya and decided to help her out and bring her to the hospital. But obviously the police weren't buying that, and the man eventually broke down and told the police that he had gone over to an apartment complex to purchase marijuana, and that's where he and Mariah had found Anaya with a gunshot wound. They claimed that once they got to this apartment, Anaya told them that she had shot herself and she needed a ride to the hospital. But when police started interviewing people who were present at that apartment on the night of this shooting, a whole different story began to emerge. Apparently, that night, Anaya and Mariah had been in the bathroom in the apartment filming TikTok videos. And one witness stated that when they went into the bathroom, they saw Mariah holding a large black rifle, waving it around, all while Anaya was filming her for her TikTok. So at one point, this male witness said that a man entered the room. He said they needed to be careful with the rifle. They shouldn't be playing with a gun, and he tried to take it from Mariah. But Mariah allegedly said, "I need to check something first." She pulled away with the rifle in her hand, and it accidentally discharged, shooting Anaya in the stomach. And what it seems like allegedly happened is that Mariah and the others that were in the apartment then clamored and tried to hide all of the evidence, and they were the ones that ended up driving Anaya to the hospital later on. But they didn't stick around to tell investigators or anybody who they were. And obviously, they hadn't been truthful about what really happened that night the entire time. I'm eager to see how this case turns out, and I just hope that Anaya gets the justice that she deserves.
This author received a 1-star review on his book, and he went looking for that person. This is 18-year-old Paige Rowland, and she was a student nurse from Scotland. When she was not busy with studying, she really liked to read. In 2014, she read a newly published book called The World Rose by 28-year-old Richard Britton from Bedford, UK. After she read his book, she became unimpressed with the writing and grammatical errors that the book contained. That's when she decided that she was going to go on this website called Goodreads to leave an online review. Paige decided not to leave feedback, but just gave a 1-star. This did not go unnoticed by Richard. Richard was filled with rage, and he decided he was not going to let Paige get away with criticizing his book. He then decides to look her up on Facebook, and he uses the name that she has on her Goodreads account. On her profile, she had full details of where her hometown was and where she was working. Once Richard got all the details he needed, he went on a 400-mile road trip to go see Paige. On October 3rd of 2014, Richard arrives at a supermarket where Paige works, and she was actually working that day. After scoping out the whole store, that's when he finds Paige. He then grabs a bottle of wine, heads over to Paige where she's restocking shelves, and slams that bottle against her skull as hard as he can before he flees the store. Emergency services were called, and Paige suffered a horrific head injury that required stitches. Police wasted no time in tracking down Richard. His phone was traced, and his home ended up being searched, and this revealed that he was in Scotland during that time. Richard was then arrested and charged with assault of Paige and stalking of another girl. In November of 2015, a trial took place, and he pled guilty to both charges and was sentenced to 30 months in jail. In March of 2017, Richard was released and he was placed on an indefinite non-harassment order, but this wasn't the last time that Paige had contact with him. He had actually written her a handwritten letter to her home address. Once she had gotten this letter, she notified police, but prosecutors decided not to charge Richard because of his mental health. Paige was also refused criminal injury compensation because she had no long-term physical effects from the attack. Paige has moved to a secret address for safety. As for Richard, he is still free and roaming the streets.
This is by far one of the worst cartel videos ever released, and this is a massive trigger warning.
The brutal video that I'm about to explain takes place in an empty concrete room with no furniture. It looks like a scene straight from a Saw movie. As you play the video, you are immediately met with blood, and I don't say that lightly. There is literally blood everywhere. At first, when you see the victim, his torso looks like it's wrapped in saran wrap, but it's actually the shade of blood which reflects off the light. Upon playing the video, it's hard to tell if the victim is dead or alive, though his heart seems to be beating, as blood is leaking at an insane rate. The cartel member can be seen cutting the victim's throat with what appears to be a kitchen knife. After quickly slashing the victim's throat, the cartel member then takes the knife and cuts around the victim's face. From the top of his hairline down to his chin, it appears he's attempting to flay the victim's face. After cutting around the victim's face, there is so much blood that the cartel member loses his grip as he is holding the victim's head up. This then results in the victim's head falling back on the concrete ground, and as this happens, blood sprays out, leaving a streak of blood on the wall. At this point, you see the victim is somehow still alive. You see him move and attempt to breathe. The cartel member then tries to lift the victim by the head, but he can't get a grip due to the insane amount of blood. The clip then jump cuts and it shows the victim lying on his side, and the cartel member cuts his neck from behind, attempting to behead him. It jump cuts once again, showing that the victim has now been decapitated, and someone seems to kick the severed head across the room. The skin is flopping down due to the attempted flaying, and again the video jump cuts. This time showing the cartel member cutting vertically down the victim's chest and stomach, completely opening him up. You see the victim's intestines and layers of fat. It's honestly a very, very disturbing sight. The cartel member then decides to switch things up and he begins hacking away at the corpse's knees. At this point, the corpse is completely drained of blood, and it's hard to explain, but in certain videos when this happens, the flesh looks completely different. I don't know, it's just hard to explain. The video then concludes with the victim hacked into pieces, disfigured, and completely disemboweled. All I can say is thankfully the video had no sound and was dubbed by music, because I could only imagine the sounds that this video produced. The victim was almost dead at the start of the video, so who knows what took place before the camera was turned on. This video is absolutely awful and extremely bloody. Whatever you do, stay curious and never go searching for it.